Hey everybody, Graham here. So I went on the Fairfax, Virginia website and I mentioned that there was a document dump this morning. There wasn't, I was not 100% right about that. There was not a dump, but there was an order from Judge Ascarati authorizing the dump. And I have that order here, and I wanted to show it to you. So check this out. Just shrink this down and put this up. Okay, so let's take a look at this and see what we got. Just reading the initial info here, this bit. The protective order in this matter was put in place to protect sensitive information and to ensure an untainted jury. In this matter, both litigants sued one another, thereby opening themselves up to the public forum of a jury trial. Court records are public information. The case has now concluded, and therefore the court carefully reviewed all documents that were filed under seal. It appearing to the court that certain filings in this matter should be unsealed, it is therefore ordered that the following documents be unsealed. Now, this is the interesting part here. So check out all of these documents, starting with, a disclosure of expert witnesses, but basically every memo and every motion that was filed, and it's 4 pages of stuff. So, and then there are a few things that are going to remain sealed. Well, actually, quite a few things here. But looking at some of the things that are going to be unsealed, I'm kind of interested in a few of these things. I'm interested in number 6 here, right? Defendant's opposition to motion to compel independent medical examination of defendant. So this was Johnny saying that, they want Amber to be evaluated by a doctor, and this is Amber's opposition to it. So this would be the reasons that she doesn't want to be, and so I'm kind of interested to know that. What else? A lot of motions to compel disclosure and compel responses to questions and responses as to why they shouldn't have to do that. This would be an interesting one. Defendant's opposition to plaintiff's motive to compel further forensic imaging and production of testing data and expert documents. So this, I think, would be opposition to wanting to go through the photos and text messages to verify them and why they shouldn't have to do that. Motions in limine. This is going to be interesting. These are the, they kept talking about motions in limine during the trial, and we don't get to know what those are during the trial, but they're going to unseal them so we can find out what the motions in limine are. This one, I think, is going to be interesting. Excluding the testimony of Brian Neumeister. So, kind of interested to see what the. And here's the motion to exclude, and then this is the opposition to the motion to exclude. Sorry about that. Every time I tap it, it turns blue. Some potentially interesting stuff, and some of it definitely stuff that was not stuff that Amber and her team wanted to come out. Anyway, that's the update. Just wanted you to see that, and And there it is. So I'm going to be keeping an eye on this to see what happens when all these documents are actually released, and break some of it down if there's interesting stuff. In the meantime, have a great day. If there's anything else going on, I'll talk to you then. But otherwise, I'll see you in the next one. Graham out. Bye-bye.